guys, my name is Trui and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about transitions in OBS. What is a transition actually, Trui? Well, I can show you. Look at this. We're going to have some little streamception here, but sorry for that. Look. This is a transition. I will show it again. Transition is something you use between scenes to actually make it look better. Make it look cool that there's like a, not just a straight cut or a fade, but there's a transition in between. Before we're gonna go into adding them in OBS, I want to give you guys one tip first. If you're making a transition, make sure there's at least one frame that fills up the whole screen so you can cut easily. We're gonna go to streamception to actually to actually see how I do it. In the meanwhile, I probably will cover up the streamception so you guys won't see that the whole time, just with some black box in after production. What we have here is normal OBS, not Streamlabs OBS, normal OBS. To get a nice little transition, what you have to do first is, you see this part here, that's a scene transition. It's currently on Stringer, that's actually what we're gonna need, because, well, yeah, I showed you guys this, the transition already, so it's already in here. What we need to do is press the plus and select Stringer. All these other things you can do as well. You can swipe to another scene. Let's add a swipe, swipe to the left. And then that will work too, but that wouldn't be as fancy. Normally you can get it uncut or fade as well. You will see what it is. Like that. But we're currently gonna go into Stringer. So we're gonna get the plus and then go to Stringer. This box will come up. You can name your thingy. You transition. Doesn't really matter how you call it, as long as you know how it's called, okay? So you press OK, and then this new screen comes up. What you can do here is select the video file. We're gonna browse into my thingies. This is my map with layout thingies. You will see that I have made these in GIF files. You can't actually do that. You can't make them in GIF files. What you have to do if you have a GIF, go to a website and convert them to a WebM. So you see I have the WebMs here as well. Same with the brown. I've got like two colored ones. So we click on a WebM. And then you have here a transition point time. What that means is you can select time or frame. And this actually is connected with this transition point. This input will change if you change this. So this means that you can set it on milliseconds or frames. Okay, that's what this first one means. The second one is the amount of milliseconds or the amount of frames it takes until you get to the frame that your whole screen is filled with the transition. At my transition, I don't know how many seconds it is, but I know it's frame 11 because it's a GIF and we made it like in pixel art, so we know that the 11th frame is the one that fills up the whole screen, and there it needs to be a cut, because if it is in another point you will see the cut. If it is on frame 11 at my transition, it could be another frame at yours, or you might do it with a video and want to have the milliseconds. Make sure you check when it's actually full screen and make sure that it's right here. You can always change this later to another point if you see it doesn't fit. So if you don't know the exact amount of frames or seconds, you can like squeeze a bit with it in here again, make it higher or lower to see if the transition works like you intended to, right? You can also crossfade. It looks the same, but the audio will go through each other. So if you guys want to adjust this because the frames are not right or something like that, there's a little cogwheel here. You click on the cogwheel and then properties. You can rename it as well, obviously. Properties, And you can just make the frame to something else you want, or set it on milliseconds because you want it to do milliseconds at a set of frames anyway. This is how I do it. You can add as many as you want, but you can only have one active. So you can just go back to cut and then back to the screen, and then it just cuts, you know? If you do back to transitions, it makes a little transition again. Guys, if you have questions, just leave them at the bottom of this video. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, tick the little bell icon, where you know how it works. There are also socials underneath in the descriptions. And I will make more videos that explain you how to make your stream better. Because who doesn't want to make a stream better? I will see you guys next time. Bye! Thanks for watching!